What is up, everybody? Finally got that whole thing worked out, but we're good to go now. Welcome to the Ham Radio Crash Course. Thanks so much for joining us. We're going to be talking today about tuning or getting up and running on loaded vertical antennas, because there's so many cool ones out there right now, and they're kind of the hot thing everybody's talking about. So that's what we're going to be doing. Hope you guys are ready for that. And I realize the light is quickly dying where I'm going to be doing the live stream. And that's a part of daylight savings, I guess, in this time of year. But enjoy the memes, and we'll get things kicked off soon. Thanks so much for watching. And for those in the chat that are curious, what was I doing? I was definitely doing my hair, so who said that? That's what I was doing. Doing my hair like normal. All right. How's it going, everybody? I am Josh, KI6NAZ. Thanks for clicking on the Ham Radio Crash Course. Appreciate you coming out. I really do. I always try to have a lot of fun doing this. And I bit a lot off on this one. There's a lot going on, the moving parts, if you will, to make this live stream work. Because I found that the topic of loaded coil vertical antennas can be a little, not heady, but it takes a little bit of like feel to understand what's going on. So I'm going to try and guide everyone through it a little bit because people starting out with it, they seem to get like a little frustrated. A lot of people get a little frustrated. I get a lot of comments on that. So without further ado, we're gonna tap right into a little beverage here. This is a Ponto Session India Pale Ale. I definitely need to keep it sessionable here as we get started. Let's see. Is it a loaded topic? Well, it's probably a little loaded. I really like loaded verticals because they take up less space than a regular vertical. There are downsides to that, which we're going to talk about, but hopefully it all makes sense as we go through it. So thanks for bearing with me on the start there. Appreciate that. All right. All right. So let's hit some news real quick. Let's go over here. Make sure to check out the Ham Radio Crash Course. We just dropped a podcast, which is Wasps, Snakes, and Ham Shack Tools. So if you're interested in that, go check it out. I tried to had quite an interesting podcast this week. We made it just under 5 hours, which is really appreciable, I would say. HamTactical.com, your source for all of the Ham Radio Crash Course merch that's largely fueled by the podcast. So thanks, Leia, for running that, my wife. I appreciate it. You guys already saw the link there, but the ID52A is starting to make landfall, if you will. The message I was given, and I want to be really precise with my verbiage here, is that the ID52 is shipping for those that want them that have pre-orders. So you pre-ordered that, right? You pre-ordered it. If you want one, you need to pay in full if you want it there by Christmas. It is, however, not possible to cover all back orders. So keep that in mind. If you are interested in that radio, go ahead and look into it. A sessionable IPA. Anybody know what sessionable means? What the what the microbrew equivalent, what that means, sessionable? All right, what are we talking about? Let's check the chat. Let's see. RF Field Tech says, I would love to let you review my test set, but I would love to also have you let me review your test set. That would be awesome. I am very transparent. Let's see. Please let us take a peek at... You will see the Shagu soon. Yeah, so when you go buy a sessionable IPA, they come in like six, right? Well, that's a whole session. That's one session. That's kind of the joke. It just means it's lower alcohol. All right. Well, you're gonna see less of me in a second here. I realize I probably need to get a light for where I'm gonna be, what I'm gonna be doing. But let me get this going here so we can move things along, because I have a feeling I'm burning daylight. All right. So what's all this about? Well, loaded coils. So on the left hand side here, you've got what would be affectionately a quarter wave vertical antenna on 40 meters. So this is a basically 32 feet about vertical wire, and the green wires underneath it, which I'll change my color here. Okay, that's a roundabout way of doing it. But here's my mock antenna that I have in the lower left. That is my vertical quarter wave vertical antenna, And those radials, I drew a bunch of lines on them, but if we go back, hey, there we go. It's working. It's connected. So those green lines are the radials, and those radials are cut to resonance. They can be, but they don't necessarily have to be. The orange line there is your coax, and if you look, right, so along, this is the shield of the coax, and there's the pin that connects them, right? Hopefully everybody gets the idea. Well, next to it on the right-hand side is a loaded coil antenna. If you wanted to, right, if you wanted to have a full quarter wave, 40 length, 40 meter vertical, you could take 32 feet of wire and take, let's say, half of it and coil it up, kind of like on the right. And people do that to make them multi-banded. And so you've got this little alligator clip with the floating lead, and you take that little alligator clip and you click it on the side. That makes that orange part the antenna itself. So going along here, this is the active portion of the antenna going up and around the coil, right? So everything below that alligator clip is effectively shorted out, right? So this is kind of a key concept that you have to understand when you start playing with these loaded coil antennas, that you have to do this so that you can make it multi-banded. That's why things like the Wolf River coil have a floating collar that connects to a wire and you slide up and down, versus a Buddistick has those taps, right? And those taps are preset with a little screw-on nut, and then you click into the side of it, and that's all you need to do. Well, we're mainly with these antennas, we're doing gross measurements for the different bands that we're operating on by moving up and down these coils. There are advantages in the case of, we can now adjust the coil very easily to change the physical length of the antenna, right? A coil is just a reduced electrically piece of wire, a part of your whole antenna. Well, we can reduce that down, making it multi-banded, but we introduce something called Q. K8XG, thank you so much for the super chat, the 575, appreciate that. So on the top, in the middle there is just a SWR curve with a bandwidth display. And it's roughly, this is all just made up stuff. It's roughly going from 7 megahertz to 7.200 megahertz. The space here in the middle, right, the space here in the middle is kind of the usable bandwidth area, with this being the lowest frequency spot as far as your antenna match goes and your resonance. So once that's the antenna on the left-hand side, right? Your standard quarter-wave vertical antenna. Big bandwidth, right? Pretty much the whole band, a usable SWR. When you go to the antenna on the right with the coil, you're adding Q. And that Q is going to narrow the bandwidth here in the... Come on now. Is going to narrow the bandwidth in the middle, meaning that you have shortened or reduced the usable bandwidth, but you now have the agility, frequency agility, if you will, to step up and down through the different bands or frequency spaces. So if you don't like that particular tap point, let's say in the, call it like 7.100, right? You want it to be more at the 7.200 space, then you would slide to the right, which would be you would shorten the coil. You would shorten or deaden what is part of the antenna. So instead of tapping where that alligator spot is, maybe you tap it right here. So now that's the tap point. So you come up here with your alligator and you tap off that item on the right. That allows you to effectively shorten the antenna. And by shortening the antenna, you move up the frequency. So now that middle point might be that 7.200 megahertz. Hopefully that makes sense, right? I hope it does anyway. That's the goal of this. So let me go back a step. Let's do this one. So another way of looking at this is, so here's your Wolf River coil on the left here. It is 1/4 wavelength radials. Basically, you get three of them when you buy a Wolf River coil. And they're roughly, by the way, they come at one length and you just adjust the vertical around them, and they're not explicitly tuned. They're just kind of like a good length. They're probably tuned for the lowest band of effective operation, which is 40 meters or about. And so this is what the coil looks like, right? Everything here is shorted out of the antenna system. You have removed it by sliding this collar. Oop, we got the wrong. I need a new. Give me that. We have effectively used this collar to short out everything that's on the lower side going to the coax versus up here is all part of the active antenna. So every one of these coils, this wraps around the PVC pipe, adds physical length to your antenna, right? That's the key point here, the key takeaway, if you will. With a Wolf River coil, you're making all your adjustments for SWR, or your resonant spot, your match. Those are all words that not are necessarily the same. They all have their own descriptions and definitions, but you're messing with all of them as you go up or down with that collar. Ham Radio Hobo says, more radials are better. And generally, that's true up to a certain point. And that's a good transition for the next point. On the Buddistick, we are adjusting the radial for resonance. It's actually a part of how we get a tune and actually a pretty good match for the antenna. And because we are using a elevated radial, then we don't need as many radials themselves. So more is better, yes, if you're going to ground mount your radials. And what is a radial? It's basically like a ground plane. It's, as I have been told, it's a way of looking at it. I don't know it's the most accurate way. It's something for your RF to push off of. Because if you were to think about it in other terms, a vertical antenna is really just half of a dipole. If you think of the whip right here, right? That is the vertical portion of the antenna. That's one leg, the positive pin on your coax, right? This, on the other hand, is the other leg of the dipole, this part here, which is your radial. With an elevated radial, we can do with much less, but by using only one, we will get kind of a null that would be somewhere likely over here and somewhat over here, potentially, but not necessarily true. There are plenty of academic articles that you can go look at and don't necessarily shake what I'm saying as fact, but that's generally been my experience. So anyway, okay. So those are my simple drawings that I wanted to cover before we do something a bit fun. So I'm going to do something right here. And it is completely dark outside, so this is going to be I don't even know how this is going to go. So what are we doing? Well, I'm clipping on a mic. Okay, now you should only hear one mic. Do you only hear one mic? Yeah, you do. Okay, good. Hopefully this will work. And I need to put in my AirPods. First time watching, says 85 El Camino 11. Well, thank you for watching, but who, buddy? This may not be the best time to watch. Let's see. Let's flip over here. See if this all works out. We'll see right now. Okay, good. This will work. I think it will. Let's see. Oh my God, it's so dark. Oh man, it's so dark. Okay, I'm gonna lower this mic a little bit. I'm clipping. Let me grab something. And now I hate daylight savings. I'll tell you what. Well, I had good plans on that. I'll just take this light and move on. What do I need? Okay, I need to do this. All right, so the antenna analyzer you see on the screen is my rig expert. And I am going to slide outside here for a second. Okay, here I am. I
should be showing up here momentarily. But okay, I've got the Wolf River connected and the Buddistick right next to it. I'm going to show you on this a bit how to tune the antenna. All right, so we're showing 1.46 on the Rig Expert. I'm going to slide down, I'm going to click down one collar, and we're going to watch it update live. Okay, that was one click. I'm going to get out of the way. I do not have a super antenna. Yeah, that's another thing. I'm literally, you're live seeing the antenna analyzer in the shack. Okay, so that one click down brought our resonance point. Actually, let me watch this. So let me go up two then. So where we were. I'm now shortening the antenna. Joe Wobb, the antenna analyzer I'm using is Bluetooth, but my phone is now the webcam, and you can't see the Rig Expert if I'm looking at it on a screen. It's one or the other. You use the screen on the Rig Expert, or you use your application on your phone. Okay, so now that kicked that resonance spot way up. That's where we should have it. So I've dropped it down now. Armando A, it's not that I'm not scared, it's that I'm doing this for you. I would never leave these out. Okay, so pretty good. That one click down, we are looking at 1.175 megahertz, giving us a SWR of 1.16. That's about exactly where we'd want to be with this. Now, I will note, I am running the Chameleon 17-foot vertical whip here, the telescopic. MFJ sells one of these as well. What I'm doing with this is, effectively, that 17 feet is already 20 meters. So really, the only portion that's the coil is this part right here at the top. So I don't introduce that much Q, actually. So if you're going to go with the Wolf River coil, you should definitely get the 17-foot extension. You'll do a lot better with that. All right, let's talk about the Buddistick Pro. All right, the Buddistick Pro is different, right? With the Buddistick Pro, we have to tap differently. So right now I've got this tapped for 20 meters. I'm gonna bring this around and I'm gonna click in on the tap point for 40. I also then have to tune the radial appropriately by lengthening it out because, oh, no, I guess I don't. Well, no, I haven't changed the coax yet. And yeah, I did actually set up two links of coax and had a little connector. Okay, I'm looking at my own live stream. I'm watching my own live stream. Wow. Okay, I didn't expect it to be that good, to be honest. I will throw a shout out to the Ham Radio Clubhouse guys, this side of the radio. Yep, let me show you. The absolute requirement, if you're going to use the Buddistick Pro, is go get yourself one of these electric fence posts. This thing is awesome. This is exactly what you want to use if you're playing around with the adjustable radial. So I'm going to unclip this. Okay. So this guy has little keyed out little, what do you call this? Heat shrink tubing. What we're going to do with this is, I had this set up for 20 meters. I don't have a lot of space in my front yard, so I'm going to slide him over. We may be off shot a little bit. I apologize. I'm going to start lengthening this out. And we're literally going to lengthen this or shorten this live looking at my SWR meter. I'm going to run this out here. Okay. Yeah, when I go back in the shack, I'll talk about how I have these configured. This is indeed the mega tripod. I do not recommend anyone get anything but the mega tripod. Thank you, Dave S., for the super chat. I also saw Vern in there. Vern, thank you so much. Appreciate your support. Okay, this is obviously not the right length for the radial, so I'm gonna start walking it out, basically going into my neighbor's yard a bit. Can you still see the, you can, okay. I'm gonna lengthen this. Try not to get all up in my neighbor's yard right now. Okay, let's check that. That's a little low. So that coupling that you saw was me holding the wire. So we're not long enough yet. So I'm gonna go do some funky stuff right now. I didn't expect to have to make the wire so long. All right, so I've lengthened the wire, right? I've taken it off, uncoiled it from the wire winder. And we're still not long enough. So I'm gonna take off a couple more turns or, you know, unwind. Okay. Let's see where we ended up. Okay, so while I was touching it, it was good. Getting better. All right, we need to make it. Well, actually, what's probably going to be best at this point is if I use my my rig. I have another rig expert out here just in case I needed a fine tune, because I would like to see the actual bandwidth right now. So I'm going to disconnect. Okay. It's actually a bit too short, which is kind of what we expected. Oh my gosh. I need a minute. Hold on. Okay, we're gonna adjust the radial a minute. Give it a little bit more. All right, how do we do? So when I'm playing with it, you can see it's good. Okay, on my back. I'm starting to get too far away from the receiver. Okay, so now we've gotten to a point where we've definitely probably have the radial where we want it. And I'll take another tune here. Another plot. We probably don't want to adjust the radial again necessarily. Okay. So let me see if I can show you this. So in lengthening out, pulling out the radial, we've actually messed with the antenna. The best SWR showing now is a 2, which is kind of not what we want. Can you see that? No, you cannot. It might be too bright. Oh, you can see it a bit. That's the backlight against everything else. It's too bright. So now we're going to go back to the other The camera is in the window. Yes. So we've lengthened it to the point where we've now kind of gone to the other side, but we still need the antenna to be longer. So what do we do? Well, we got two options. The Buddistick manual would tell you that all you need to do is lengthen or shorten the radial, but that's not likely the case. Sometimes you need to change the tap point to the other side of the coil. So I'm going to do that. We're going to try it. Okay. You have tap points actually all around the coil. And now when I tap in again here, let's see what we get. All right. So we've adjusted the tap points now. I kind of messed with this antenna on purpose so that you can go through the process with me, or I can demonstrate the process. Let's see where the curve is now, or the dip. I've disconnected from that tuner. Okay, now it's way, way long. All right, so we have lengthened the vertical and the radial seems to be happy with that, but it's not where we want it to be. So it's probably the wrong tap point. The gazebo cannot be an antenna, no. Here we go. Stop running, please. You're gonna trip on things. Stop running. No, you cannot run out here right now. Here, buddy. All right. We went with the long tap. So we're going to go to this guy. That light back. Thank you, Edison. See how we do with that. And my analyzer just went out. What happened there? I hit the timeout timer, I guess. I thought I set that thing for 60 minutes. We're gonna do another test. Okay, so I adjusted the tap. So I've got the dip where I want it, but it's not perfect, right? I want to lower that SWR. So let's pull in a bit of the radial. Now I mess with this antenna a bit to give myself a bit of a harder time. Okay. So there you go. Now you can likely do better than this, but that is where we're at right now. And that's where I'm gonna go for right now, just so I can go back inside and we can keep talking. But you can keep adjusting this and moving. Some of this is gonna be dictated by your alignment for the radials, how you have the antenna constructed, if it's up against any metal, stuff like that is going to affect that. I'm going to reconnect the Wolf River coil. And I'm going to get the radio out of the neighbor's yard. Looking at the chat. I will answer your questions when I get back inside my shacky shack here. The only thing that for me, I would like a little bit better with the Buddistick Pro. This radial wire is green. Oh man, you don't want people to walk into this. While I'm out here, I'm going to take another pass on the Wolf River to make sure that we're still good. Holy smokes! That's wild. Where is that low? Okay, this is a bit too short. But look how low that dip is. So maybe if I just go in there and shorten it a touch, we can get that to line up even better. Let me try. One click. Oh, sorry. It's too short. So I need to lengthen it. That was two clicks, right? Oh, yeah. Now it's a little too long. Well, so, okay. Let me show you this so you understand. Now the dip is on the low side of the coil. So with the Wolf River, you can do this a bit with the Buddistick, but it's not really designed for it. You have to move the tap points if you want to do this. With the Wolf River, though, because it has that collar, I can simply just go in and rotate it left or right to lengthen or shorten it. So give it about a half inch turn. A little bit better. So we've nudged it a bit. And there you go. Perfect. I don't know that I'm in frame or not, but I think I am. Okay, so we started out with these antennas in 20 meters, and we've now adjusted them for 40 meters. That was how we started. And I'm gonna go inside, and I'm gonna show you some plots so you get a better view of what's going on. I'm reconnecting to the long coax. And let's go inside. Thank you for dealing with this ridiculousness. They locked me out of my house. Thanks. Next time, I will definitely add a little bit of lighting out there. This is much more of a summer live stream, I guess. Let me switch back to my good mic.
Okay, I am back. Let's go over here really quick. All right. What time is it? Oh my gosh, it was almost perfect. I mean, I screwed up in the beginning, lost about 5 minutes, and then that stupid video not popping up, but all right. All right, so if you want to at me, at Ham Radio Crash Course in the chat, I'll take your questions. But let's cover a couple of the vertical antennas that are out there on the market. I'm most familiar with the Wolf River and the Buddistick Pro. I've definitely spent more time using the Wolf River because I've had it much longer. The Wolf River gives you a bit more to play with because it will go all the way down to 80 at the price point that is competitive with the Buddistick Pro, right? So Buddistick Pro is $199, and if you add shock cord, if you want the legs, that kicks it up to like basically $257 and some change. You don't need the coax. Wait, what is this? Please add. Oh, if you want the 25-foot cable, that's another $26. So it kind of goes up in price when you talk as you get going through it. Wolf River has a ton of different options. Actually, let me go back a step for the Buddistick. There are a couple of things to note too. You can get a clamp. They have a different kind of tripod, and they also have an extension, a longer coil. Where is the big boy coil? Ooh, hey, let's check this out for a second. Where's that? Let me see your choke balance. Huh. Interesting. That's kind of cool. So that taps out. Coil set. Here we go. So that's the buddy pole. That's the dipole. You don't necessarily need that, but you could use the longer coils. Low band coil. There we go. So there's your low band coil. That's what gets you down to... Ooh, it's got a counterpoise kit too. You'll have to get that if you want to get down to like 80 meters. Because again, Buddistick Pro tops out at 40 meters, whereas the Wolf River will go down to 80. Daniel McCormick says, I have the Platinum WRC. Does adding more radios reduce receive noise at all? So adding more radios will not reduce noise. That will not affect noise at all. That is not what radials do. You could potentially add a choke ballon. The choke ballon somewhere along the feed line, a one-to-one choke ballon, could help reduce noise. So let's go over to Wolf River for a second. There is a ton of Wolf Rivers, and it's already been mentioned in the chat. Yeah, everything that's been mentioned so far is really good. I saw Kate MRD is in the house. He's an absolute whiz with the Wolf River. Go check out K8MRD radio stuff. He's got a ton of videos on the Wolf River, way more than mine. Most of my videos are with operating with the Wolf River, just kind of in the background. The one I recommend is the Silver Bullet 1000 80 through 10 meters with the Mega Tripod. You gotta get the Mega Tripod. That is the top recommendation I have for this. All the other ones, it's up to you. They're all really good. Regardless of what it is, you should get the Mega Tripod. There is a Take It Along Mini. So it's the Mega Tripod with the Mini Coil. That's going to reduce the bands that you can operate on, but it's there. You could add a longer whip with a less coil and still get out as far into 80 meters if you want. Don says, Don in the chat has said he's used the WRC on 60 and both work well. They also have a center loading kit. So one of the big differences between, where is that center loading kit? I know it's down here somewhere. They got all kinds of like weird stuff, man. Where's that center loading? There it is. So there's a center loaded right here, center loading kit. And what that does is it does kind of like what the Buddistick Pro does. It puts the coil, the loading coil, at the middle of the mast or higher up than right at the base, which is its base loaded right now. Base loading generally is believed to not radiate as well. It messes with your takeoff angles. Versus if it's center loaded, it has better takeoff angles. I believe it lowers the takeoff angles when you do center loading. Oh, Andrew Wells, good point. I do need to mention that as well. Okay, let me go back a step. There is a Take It Along 1000 Magnum. I don't know why they picked that name, but Platinum. Is it Platinum? Platinum? Is it Platinum? There it is, Platinum. Okay, the reason for the Platinum, it's basically the same thing, but it will take 100 watts of digital. So it's $165 and you'll get the 100 watts for digital. If you don't do that with the Wolf River coil, you will get a sad Wolf River coil and the actual PVC pipe will start to droop on you. If you take the standard Take It Along 1000 and you try and put 100 watts of FT8 in it, or wind link will definitely melt it. It'll go brrr, and you'll get a sad Wolf River coil. Okay, let's see. Last one, super antenna. I wasn't going to mention this because honestly, I don't have it. No, not the supper antenna. Now, I am not endorsing this antenna. I've never used this antenna. I know a pretty decent amount of people that have used it and they have bought it and they have sold it and they didn't like it. So take that what you will. They are available on amazon.com. You can find them. It's very similar, except it's more of a outer shell that slides up and down. They are pretty expensive. So this is the $499 one. You can see it's got a couple of coils and they actually adjust on the outside and there is a gauge there. I just pull this up. There we go. There's a gauge right here that will actually help you adjust the length for bands. It does have a tripod. The tripod looks a lot like the Wolf River coil. It has this multi-tapped mount with a C-clamp. I'm not recommending it. I'm not a user. I'm just letting you know they exist. If you do find a run on one or you've got some you can get access to if you want to try it, you can do that. Uber Geek, how hard are they to build? Oh, good question. And you know what? Let's do that. I didn't plan on doing this, but we'll just do it live. So Thingiverse has a couple of projects on making a loading coil, an antenna loading coil. And you can see it right here in use. Look at that. It's got a little tap section. There's your coax at the bottom. That looks a whole lot like some of the things we talked about. The difference is that you'll likely be running a wire up that vertical. You could potentially mount some kind of, what is it, 3/4 20 on the top of that coil and screw in an actual metal telescopic whip. If you're going to do that, you probably will not be able to use PLA. You'll have to use something a little more rigid, maybe like ABS Or you can just run a wire up a fishing pole, a telescopic fishing pole, and use it that way. And then you can just tap it to adjust the bands of operation. And that's free, right? Or as free as 3D printing is to you. Ham Radio Pen Pals says, I bought the super antenna and sold it quickly. All right, let me go back here for a second and show you what we ended up with the Wolf River Coil. All right, so we're going to take a single check. Oh, baby, look at that. So let's take a plot. We'll go to free, so I'm clicking the right arrow. Check this out. Ba-dow. So that's where we ended up. Enhance. And I'm not even centered on it. I didn't even get perfectly on it. For those of you that are like, well, hey, the Take Along 1000 must be better than the Buddistick then. No. Just because the SWR gets lower, that doesn't mean it's going to perform better. Also, further, I've got the Buddistick in all kinds of stupid configuration for this video. Nor would I normally set them up next to each other. I wouldn't do anything like I'm doing right now. This is purely for demonstration. Yeah, so there you go. That's 1 megahertz. Look at that steep V there in the middle. 1 megahertz bandwidth view, and you can see the Q factor, right? How it starts to turn into a bit of a deep valley. So yeah, there you go, guys. I will like to point out that everything I've talked about today, I bought all this stuff, right? I bought all these antennas. I'm talking about antennas I've bought. I'm using stuff that I've bought. I am not affiliated with Wolf River Coil, and I'm not affiliated with Buddistick. So these are really my thoughts straight up. And if I was given anything, I would let you know. And I think that it wouldn't have any effect on my opinions on those two antennas. They are very good antennas. But, and again, I started this whole video off this way. Some of you, most of you, are going to get frustrated the first time you set these up. You will. Take your time with it. If you have only a radio with an SWR meter, you're going to get even more frustrated. Possibly get yourself a nano VNA for testing it out. Nano VNAs do make it easier for doing that sweep, right? And getting a little bit more information that you can run with. But seriously, take your time. Set this up at home the first couple of times. Play radio with it at home before you go out into the field and do expect to just pull it out of the package for the first time and make it all work. So those are my recommendations, my final thoughts there. Guys, if you have more questions or you want to talk about any of this stuff, join us over on the Discord. I'm going to hop over on the Discord for the Ham Radio Crash Course after chat. I probably bet, maybe I'm wrong, but we might see Mike K at MRD there because we are talking about the Wolf River Coil and antennas in general. So you'll have a lot of people that are experienced with them in the house. So yeah, definitely consider joining us over there and join the Facebook group as well. We've got a great group of people. We've got fantastic admins. It's about radio, fun with radio, no gatekeeping. You can ask questions and you'll get the help you need, I promise. So that's what I got to say today. Next week is Thanksgiving. I will live stream Thanksgiving Saturday, and we are on for Ham Nation on Wednesday before Thanksgiving. So big week of ham radio, and I will be dropping my first look at the 6100 before Ham Nation. So the Shegu 6100, so keep that in mind. Okay. How's everybody doing in the chat? Everybody good? I love Elmers. What do you mean no love for the Elmers? I love Elmers. I like to call them mentors. I think you know that, but you know. All right, let's give a big hearty thank you to the patrons here. Thank you everybody that supports me on Patreon and the YouTube supporters as well. I got to figure out something to do for you guys. But yeah, you get to view the videos early, right? That's kind of why that exists. So thank you for that. But yeah, big thanks to the patrons. You guys really do help support all of this. Allow me to buy those two antennas, for instance. So that definitely went into that. And I appreciate that. Thank you. Gaptastic says, I've yet to meet an Elmer. Yeah, I've definitely met Elmer, people that would call themselves Elmers, and people who would probably prefer to be referred to as mentors. I've met a ton. So Armando A, thanks. I hope this looked better than I feel it came out, because I feel like this came out like trash. So thank you. It was very ambitious on my part. I respect that. I bit off a lot on this one, and I will definitely be maybe setting up some lighting next time, which I could have done because I have battery-powered lights. I could have just done that. But then I'd really be a weirdo in the front yard with that. Yeah, IT guy, I agree. Hang out in HRO, you'll meet some. Join the Discord and you'll meet some too. And you know what? Let me throw a thought out on Elmers. An Elmer doesn't necessarily have to be like the wizard, the Gandalf from Harry Potter that knows everything about everything. They could be experienced in a tiny little sliver of information. It just so happens that that's the sliver of information you need. For other things, they may be more of a newcomer than you. But they may have a willingness to walk with you through the learning process and learn something new together. Sometimes an Elmer isn't really someone who already knows. It's someone who knows how to find the answer or solution to a problem because of what they already know. They can draw on things that their mind has made mental connections with, and you get to where you're going that way. So big thank you to the Brew Crew and the patrons. That's the wrong one. There it is. Thank you so much, guys. I hope you enjoyed this. W8KJR Evan says, you need an Olight Marauder. Could you imagine? This thing's 5 feet away from me and just melting my retinas. Anyway, please do join us over on the Discord. I'm going to go take down these antennas. So I'll see you in there about 5-10 minutes. And I will be simulcasting to Twitch. All right, you guys enjoy the memes. I'll play you off. 73. Go join us over in the Discord, everybody. I'll see you there. And like I said, about 5-10 minutes. Gotta take down all these antennas. I may leave the Wolf River up for